Okay.
As beautiful as all that really was, it is not the movie that you are about to watch. This one is. The one with lakes instead of deserts, people falling into the water instead of fighting over it, and dying. An odd husband with a crazy mustache.
Go on, that was a nosebleed.
Instead of a crazy general with an odd mustache. And finally, you'll be watching the movie where trains just pass through a station instead of the movie where trains just pass through the desert and get blown up. But before you start to feel cheated or that you chose the wrong movie, it's important you know something about what these two movies really have in common besides trains. See this? And this? It's the same director. This movie, Lawrence of Arabia, was nominated for 10 Academy Awards in 1963, winning 7, including Best Picture and Best Director. Its visual style influenced many other directors, including George Lucas and Steven Spielberg, and it is regarded as a masterpiece of world cinema. Again, don't leave the theater, because Brief Encounter was nominated in 1945 for Academy Awards as well, that of Best Director and Best Screenplay. And as film critics note, it is in Brief Encounter where all of the key elements that David Lean would later exploit in award-winning pictures such as Lawrence of Arabia manifested themselves for the first time. But just what were those elements that make directors such as David Lean and movies such as Lawrence of Arabia so critically acclaimed? Let's look at two of those elements that Lean uses in this movie, Brief Encounter. The story elements such as irony, foreshadowing, and flashback, and the art direction such as lighting and blocking. Let's look at an example of some of these elements. It comes after an extremely awkward moment at the beginning of the film, right before the main characters are separated. Seen here. Later on in the train, Laura, the point of view character, that is, the character to whom the camera is partial, displaying her perspective throughout the movie, is chatting with a friend and then begins to reflect on all that has brought her up to the present moment. Instead of having fancy technology for the flashbacks, Lean had to creatively compromise with special blocking and lighting. To achieve the effect, he used what are called unmotivated camera movements, that is, movements that are not motivated by an actor's action, and unique lighting manipulation. Let's see how this comes together. Notice how the camera begins to gently dolly forward, the sound fades out, and music comes in, and the light dims around Laura's face as we hear her narration. This sequence establishes, for the rest of the movie, how we will know when a flashback is about to occur. Once such a sequence is established, any good director will know that it must remain constant, and indeed it does. Watch for it. Blocking is a placement or movement of the camera, and the placement or movement of the actors in relation to the camera. A special form of this placement and movement that utilizes what objects are placed in a scene to convey a figurative meaning is known as mise-en-scene. Let's look at an example. Here we have Laura trying to explain to her husband what happened earlier that day while she was out doing her weekly shopping and movie watching. At that movie, we see a bit of foreshadowing coming from the movie's title, Flames of Passion, which is, ironically, followed by some advertisement about a baby carriage. I wonder what the director is trying to say. Now look back, and notice where the fire is in this scene. It's behind Laura, who is in front of a crossword puzzle wall separating her from her inattentive and naive husband. Of all the places in the room that the camera could have been, the director very carefully selected this one. Any guesses as to why? Mise-en-scene. It conveys something. I'll let you interpret exactly what this conveys to you, but just know that this is not an accident. Here's another carefully thought out scene that serves as an additional example of mise-en-scene and camera blocking. It is a scene at the train station after Alec and Laura have expressed their love to each other. See the sign in the background labeled Way Out? Notice what the director has Alec do as Laura begs him not to kiss her, and you'll see your mise-en-scene. Notice how Alec blocks the way out? Now watch what happens after they kiss. So why does the camera pull back so far so immediately? It is meant to match our disgust for such a repulsive scene. As we push the scene away emotionally, the camera helps us out. This camera movement is safe for this scene in particular, heightening its effect, the mark of a good director. Okay, here's one you all can find on your own. There's one other camera movement that is safe for a particular moment like the last one was. It's towards the end of the movie, so, not wanting to spoil, just take a mental note of this scene and be ready to watch for it. Notice first, what Lean does with the camera, it will be something very obvious and new, and second, what kind of feeling it creates inside you while watching. Ultimately, using all of these elements is what won David Lean his awards. His ability to make the film with an audience's eye allowed him to heighten the emotions with each camera movement. The artistic achievement, the believable characters, The smart use of music and the very clever linguistic irony found throughout Brief Encounter all make your movie choice tonight one of the best. You will not be disappointed. By understanding these elements, the hope is not that you immediately become award-winning directors, though honestly, that is the most I could hope for. But much like understanding watercolors and brushstrokes deepens the appreciation of a watercolor painting, the very least I could hope for is that there is a deepened appreciation of the artistic achievement in this film and film in general, and that you will now, with this increased understanding, enjoy Brief Encounter just a little bit more.